In the following minutes, you will discover the brand new step-by-step video tutorial that will explain everything you need to know about this revolutionary product. So keep watching.
Okay, all right. Section 609, attorney letter. Probably my favorite of all of the different methods. Quite effective. All right, let's get right down to it. So Section 609 credit letter simply requests under federal law that the credit reporting agencies provide you a copy of the original creditor contract, which they should have used to verify the account as being valid and correct. Now, they're required under federal law to keep this information on file, but since they do not verify the account information, they do not have this information on file, and as a result, they cannot provide it to you. Now, under the Fair Credit Reporting Act, like we talked about earlier, reporting agencies must provide a copy of the verifiable original creditor documentation if it is requested by you, the consumer. Since they cannot provide verification to you in the form of a physical contract document per your written request, the account is classified as unverified, and under the Fair Credit Reporting Act, all unverified accounts must be deleted. Whether the account is correct or not makes no difference. If it's unverified in an account, it must be deleted. This is why and how the Section 609 credit repair letter works. Keep in mind, results will vary. You may send a letter and get virtually all of your derogatory information removed, or you may send a letter and only get a few accounts removed. Don't be discouraged. Now, it's important to be diligent and persistent. If after the first round of letters, derogatory information still remains, then simply send the letter again, emphasizing that this is now your second written request to receive verifiable proof or the account or have it deleted. Eventually, you're going to find that your derogatory accounts will begin to disappear. For some people, it happens very, very quickly, and it's quite easy, and for others, it can be a challenge. So be prepared to go a few rounds of letters if required. Now, what to expect? Like, when you send in your certified letter to the credit report, to the reporting agencies, many times they're going to attempt to disregard your request and send you bogus reply communications. Expect to receive any number of responses. They may be intimidating, and they may intimidate you try to pursuing the issue further. Experian, Equifax, or TransUnion may send you a communication saying something like this. We received a suspicious request regarding your personal credit information that we have determined was not sent by you. We have not taken any action on this request, and any further requests made in this manner will not be processed and will not receive a response. Really? Exactly how did they determine it was not sent by you? Now, the letter was notarized and included a copy of your social and an ID card. Now, so they just determined this, right? Now, to further scare you into submission, they may also include something like this. Suspicious requests are taken seriously and reviewed by security personnel who will report deceptive activity, including copies of letters deemed as suspicious, to law enforcement officials and to state or federal regulatory agencies. Do not be fooled by this. These are nothing but scare tactics to intimidate you into giving up. Now, review each report and identify all the negative items to remove, and simply copy the negative information from your corresponding credit reports into the letter as you see on the screen and to send it to the credit reporting agency. Now, don't dispute more than a maximum of 22 accounts. You see on here where it says 1, 2, 3, no more than 22 total accounts. Now, if you do more than 22 accounts, attempting to dispute more than that could result in classifying the dispute as frivolous, and you don't want to do that. It means you can't dispute that for another 6 months. Now, you review your report, and you see that there's 3 negative accounts to remove. Simply open up the Section 609 attorney credit letter and type in the detail from the negative accounts you want to remove. That's it. Just put in the account number and the account name. Now, once you complete each letter, simply have your signature notarized, include a photocopy of your social security and your ID card as proof of identity, and mail the letter certified mail. Now, if your ID card does not have your current home address on it, you want to also include 2 utility type statements or a bank statement that shows your current home address for proof of residence at the same time. Now, you want to send it certified mail. Like I said, this is going to enable you to track delivery of your letter and provide proof that it was received by the reporting agency, should it come down to that later. Now, the next step is to watch the mail closely for responses. If you receive a response and some negative items were not removed, and they did not provide you with a written verifiable proof per your request, then send the letter again. Simply rinse and repeat. It's recommended that you open a file folder for each of the 3 bureaus, one for Equifax, Experian, and TransUnion, and keep very detailed records of your communication with each reporting agency. It's important that you establish a paper trail history of your efforts to enforce your consumer rights under the Fair Credit Reporting Act. Document everything in writing, keep copies of letters, certified mail receipts, response letters, notes, etc. Over time, you're going to build a very strong case against the agency, and this evidence will be invaluable should you ever have to go to the unusual extreme of filing a lawsuit to seek damages. But should you have to go to that extreme, by keeping good notes, you're going to win that. So that would be the Section 609 letter. Here is a copy of it. You can find it next to this video in the training area. That way you don't have to reinvent the wheel here. Everything is copy and paste. Use the letter that's provided for you. You do not need to handwrite this letter like you do the identity theft report. You get much more better results with that one with a handwritten letter. This one, not as big a deal to handwrite it. So this one's super fast and easy. I hope you enjoyed it and put it to good use. With that, see you on the next video.
Thanks for watching. I hope you got a lot from it. Don't forget to click the link below for my special discounted price.